Buddha boy.
Okay. Hi everyone, welcome to episode number 41 of So Not Scary. In today's episode, I'm going to show you how I made these homemade hankies with mitered corners only by using our mini sewing machine. Hooray! I started off with some plain cotton flannel and I just pressed it out using a hot iron. And then taking it to my cutting board, I squared off one edge and then cut off a length of the fabric of whatever length basically that I liked. And then I squared off all of its edges using my rotary cutter and my quilting ruler. That was really quick and easy. And now, after all the four edges had been squared up, I simply turned it over onto its wrong side and then folded all the edges down, making a really narrow folded over edge, and I pressed everything down. Once it's been pressed down, I used my quilting ruler and I marked 1 inch from each corner. So that's a 1 inch mark on both the edges and then 1 inch marks along all the other three corners as well. And the idea is that these 1 inch marks would help me create the mitered corners that we are looking for in these homemade hankies. Mitered corners basically give your project a really nice, neat, finished edge. There they are. And now what I'm going to do is simply taking my ruler, I'm going to connect those two dots, creating essentially an isosceles triangle in all the four corners of our hanky. So that's really quick and easy. Just simply taking my ruler and my pen, I'm going along drawing straight lines connecting those two dots that we just marked out. And we are approaching the last corner. And once this final line is all drawn up, you will see that this is what the corner triangle looks like. It's really straightforward. Now we're going to pick up our hanky and connect the two corners of the triangle with the right sides of the hanky facing each other like this. And then, making sure that those two points are connected, I'm going to pin this corner using a simple tailoring pin. Here we go. And we're just going to repeat the same process with all the other three remaining corners. So make sure the two points are connected, the edges are lined up equally and nicely, and then you just pin everything in place using a single pin for each corner. And once this is finished, we will be left with this kind of a shape, okay? And now we're going to take this whole thing to our mini sewing machine and we're going to sew a straight line along that pen line that we marked out on the edge of our hanky. And just to make sure that our stitching is nice and strong, we're going to go back over our stitch line one more time. So every time I sew, I'm going to pivot around and then sew back over that stitch line so that all of our stitches are nicely locked in place and they're also nice and strong. And this is a really quick and easy process. Just remember to keep removing your pins as you sew so that nothing gets caught up underneath the needle. There we are. And now, taking a pair of nice sharp scissors, I'm just going to cut away the extra fabric beyond the stitch line. And this will ensure that we have nice sharp pointy corners when we turn them right side out. So taking a pointy stick, I'm just going to turn the corners back in, and now we've got these nice sharp pointy corners. All done. And now I'm going to fold that edge over, take it to my ironing board and press it, creating a nice crisp crease, which will create our mitered corners. There it is. I've actually pinned everything down as well. Now there is my black thread guide, which we also used in this video. And now, using the thread guide, I'm now going to hem all those folded over edges using a nice simple straight stitch. And that thread guide is going to make my sewing really easy because I will find it very easy to follow that straight line. Now my cotton flannel did have a small amount of stretch to it, so it was tending to shift and slide a bit, which made it a bit of a struggle for me to sew. But even so, the thread guide simplified matters quite a great deal for me. And as soon as I reach the corner, what I'm doing is I'm leaving the needle inside the fabric and lifting the presser for pivoting the whole project by 90 degrees and carrying on. Now here we are approaching the end. Once I reach the end, you will see that I've kept the thread tails rather long. And this is because I'm going to use these nice long thread tails to manually knot the threads together and then hide everything within the folds of the fabric. And if you watch this video, you will know exactly how to do this. It's going to make it super easy. And there you have it. This is our little pocket square or homemade hanky all stitched up. And as you can see, I made lots of mistakes in making this as well. But every time I stitched a side, I got better and better. So you can see my worst side is the first side where everything was just going haywire. But as I progressed, my stitching got better, my corners got better. Look at this corner. This is like my favorite corner because it turned out to be the neatest one, okay? So yeah, I have a way to go and I have to practice making these mitered corners, but still this is perfectly usable and I can use this over and over again. I won't need to use tissues, and when it's dirty I can just toss it in the wash, press it and then reuse it over and over again. So but let's just see what the girls think. So Zoya, what do you think?
It feels really soft and like kind of foldable and easy to fit in a tight pocket.
Would you like to take it to school?
Yes.
What do you think, Miss Sophie?
Soft!
Do you want to hold it? Whoops, it's easy.
Soft, fluffy, and foldable.
Okay. So I guess we know this was a success. It was a first attempt at making mitered corners. And that too
is
something
really cool.
Thank you, Miss Sophie. So this was a first attempt at making mitered corners, especially using a mini sewing machine. Everything just gets a little bit too uncertain, but I think still in theory this worked out perfectly, and if I just practice a little more, maybe on a bit of a more forgiving fabric which is not so stretchy, I will be able to do a better job out of it. So yeah, go ahead, try making your own hankies at home so that when the time comes, when you need more tissues, and if there is a shortage out in the stores, you are not dependent upon your supermarket, and you can make your own zero waste reusable hankies at home. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I shall see you next time. Bye!